Hello learners, welcome to NIOS Studio. This program is based on Senior Secondary Chemistry course. I'm Dr. Alka Mehrotra and we'll be discussing here the lesson 5, the gaseous and the liquid state. During this part of the program, we will discuss about the gaseous and liquid state. So the objective of this program are differentiate between three states of matter, solid, liquid and gas. Describe the various types of intermolecular forces, interactions, London forces, dipole-dipole forces, dipole-induced dipole forces and hydrogen bonding. As we all know that matter exists in three different states, namely solid, liquid and gas. You are familiar with gases, liquid and solid in your daily life. You are aware that water can exist as a liquid, a solid, that is ice, and as a gas, that is vapor, under different conditions of temperature and pressure. Now here, we have already done in the junior classes that the differentiation between the solid and liquid gases are based on their intermolecular force of attraction. Now based on that, we can differentiate like shape, volume, density, compressibility also. Now shape, solid, you know, shapes are indefinite and it takes the shape of the vessel in which it is kept. Gaseous, indefinite shape. Volume, in solid, definite. Liquid, definite. And gaseous, indefinite, it fills the container completely. So the density, what about the density then? Solid has high density, liquid, the density of the liquid is lesser than the solid but much higher than the gas. And in gas, the density is very low. Compressibility. Solids are incompressible. You cannot compress the solids. Liquids, largely we can compress, but in gaseous, the compressibility is higher. Now, these properties are dependent on the intermolecular forces. Now, the difference between these three states of matter is due to the difference in their intermolecular distances and intermolecular forces. In addition to these, temperature and pressure also play an important role in deciding the states of matter. The properties of gases state can be explained in terms of large separation of molecules and very weak intermolecular forces. Now we are going to discuss about the intermolecular interactions. Intermolecular forces can be described as forces of attraction and repulsion existing between the particles of atom and molecule in a compound. The force of attraction are called van der Waals force of attraction, which include dispersion forces or London forces, dipole-dipole forces and dipole-induced dipole forces. And the example of force of repulsion is electron of one molecule repel the electron of another molecule and the nuclei of one molecule repel the nuclei of another molecule. Now let's discuss about dispersion force or London forces. We assume that electrons are evenly distributed around the nucleus. However, since electrons constantly move around the nucleus at a particular instant, the distribution of electrons may become uneven around the nucleus and result in generation of dipole with a slight negative charge on one side and an equal positive charge on the opposite side. So what happens? Thus, an ordinary non-polar species like an atom of a noble gas like argon or neon becomes polar species for an instant. And it was proposed by a German physicist Fritz London, that is why it is named as London forces. Now I'll show you with the example. Let us consider two atoms, P and Q. Let the electronic charge distribution in atom P be unsymmetrical Therefore, the charge cloud is denser at one side of the other. This leads to the generation of instantaneous dipole on atom P for a short period of time. This instantaneous dipole on an atom P alters the electron density of the atom Q placed close to it. This includes a dipole in the atom Q. The temporary dipole of atom P and Q attract each other. In the same way, temporary dipole are included in the molecules too. So we can say this is a temporary attraction. Now let's move on to dipole-dipole attraction. If molecules of substance are polar in nature, the positive end of one dipole attracts the negative end of the other. These interactions are quite strong as compared to the London forces and increase the melting and boiling point of polar compounds, such as ethers. As compared to those of similar non-polar compounds, such as hydrocarbons, that have nearly the same molecular mass. Now next is dipole-induced dipole forces. These interactions are between polar molecule and non-polar molecule. The polar molecule induces a dipole in the neighboring non-polar molecule and an electrostatic force of attraction starts operating between them. So, we can say about dipole-induced dipole forces that the magnitude of these forces depend on two factors. Number one, dipole moment of the polar molecule. And so, the greater the dipole moment, stronger is the attractive force. And the number two, polarizability of non-polar molecule. So, more polarizable is the non-polar molecule, greater is the dipole moment of the induced dipole and stronger is the attractive force. Now, we move on to the hydrogen bonding. This kind of bond is found in molecules having high polar bonds, for instance, nitrogen-hydrogen, oxygen-hydrogen and hydrogen-fluorine. So, here, the atoms which are more electronegative in nature will form hydrogen bond with hydrogen. So, hydrogen bonding is responsible for some unusual properties of water, like its existence in liquid state over a wide range of 100 degree, that is 273 Kelvin to 373 Kelvin, high heats of fusion and vaporization, and its solid form, ice, being lighter than liquid water. Now let's revise what we have studied so far. We have done that matter exists in three states, namely solid, liquid and gas. And now I'm sure you know about the properties of these. Then we have studied the three states of matter differ in the relative closeness of molecules constituting them. And we have studied about the intermolecular interactions present depending on the nature of the substance. So, what we have studied? We have studied that there are three states of matter, solid, liquid and gas. There is one more state of matter, that is plasma state, that we have not included in this topic. Now, as you know that solid, liquid and gases can be differentiated in various ways, and the major cause why they are differentiated, this is because of the intermolecular forces or intermolecular interactions. And we have studied like London forces, we have studied dipole-dipole forces, we have studied dipole-induced dipole forces and hydrogen bonding, and you have noticed that how they react and how they affect the substance or the nature of the substance. I'm sure you have understood the topic. Thank you.